Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com and welcome back to the channel. And welcome back to this awesome tutorial series on Duck UI. And today we are going to go further with lists. So let's just jump right into the code. Okay, in the previous episode, we have created our simple newsfeed view controller that has a list of posts. Today, I'm just going to a little bit customize all of this because, yeah, it is pretty straightforward. I have gone through mostly everything that you can customize, but let's just have a hands-on experience on that. But first of all, let's just build this on our simulator and see what we got. Well, we have our newsfeed navigation item, and we have these cells, we can tap on them. And we have these feedbacks on the log. Maybe we can tap on the cell, just on the cell too. And yeah, let's just customize all of this. And one thing that I'm pretty sure that you want to first customize is, let's see, let's have some more here. So let me just copy these around and just paste some more. Let's not forget about the commas here. And it doesn't really matter about the UID just now. So let's see, let's build and run again and see how they look. Of course, this is manually added and now you can see that it is scrollable. Pretty nice. Okay, again, this is manually added, but you will most probably fetch some data in the fetch data function and you will add that array of posts to the items just there, or just append some more. Okay, you could just append. And yeah, this is just for testing out your UI. Okay, next up, let's just have some, let's see, some left padding, maybe some right padding, so we can see how that looks like. Okay, just to, so you can visualize what this padding is all about. Okay, you can see here we have our 10 and 10. And now that we did have that padding, we need to correct our size for item. And we need to extract here from all of this, from the self view, we need to extract those two paddings, so 20. And then again, those two for the inter-item spacing and divided by 3. So that's how we get the width of our cell. Let's do that, and now we should see those three aligned there. Okay, there we have it. Great. And of course, if we wanted to, we can have a top of 50, maybe. I don't know, why would you do that? Maybe if you want to have, that is your option. We have this 50 here. Okay, that's that. And of course you could have a bottom there, but I won't bother with that. So that's for padding. Let's just add that back here and let's just remove this from there. And what I want to add here is, you saw that we added some padding on the top and maybe you want to add some views there. Well, we won't have to use padding because yeah, you can't add any views on the padding. So we are going to add a top view, and if you uncomment this add top view of height 20, then you will see 200, sorry, then you will see a top view right here. Okay, there we go. How awesome is that? Okay, now again, this isn't a header. We will talk about headers that will move with the scroll view up. This is a top view, and if you wanted to, you could add, let's say, a bottom view. So self.bottom view, or rather yet, add bottom view of height. Let's see, let's have this just with the 100. And of course, you can add a leading and a trailing view. I won't bother adding or explaining that to you. Okay, there you go. Here we have our bottom view. There we go. Great. Let's just remove this, and you want to basically add some views to this top view. And for now, let's just create a label. This is real bad practice. I would most probably, oh, let's just add that there. Let's not be lazy. Let's add this up here under views, and let's create a label. It's a simple label. UI label. And I will add some text to it, and let's see. Doc, or another yet, the list. Okay, and now let's just add this label to our top view, and we could add this here or just create a separate function for that, but I would just add it here. And what we need to do is access our top view and simply add subview of our label, and maybe we want to rather center it, but let's just use stacks for this. Okay, so stack, we are just going to use a vertical stack, there we go, and let's say centering in superview, centering in parent rather, and layout in top view. There we go. If you don't know how to use stacks, then make sure that you take a look at the previous episodes. Okay, and here I will just add in my label. And that should be it. Okay, let's see how that looks like. Most probably our label will be a font, the black font. There we go, the list. Okay, and yeah, you could customize this as you'd like. Okay, what is up next? Yep. Add home indicator cover. Yeah, let's just uncomment that. Basically, we can have, let's just jump to this definition. So add home indicator cover, and we can add an add status bar cover. Well, in some cases you want to, in our case, if you just take a look at our simulator, the status bar is covered by the navigation controller, but in some cases you don't have that and you might want to have this covered. Okay, and then you have to add what was it called again? So it's add status bar cover with a background color, and the default is white. But for now, let's just show you this home indicator, and that is at the bottom of our screen. Again, it pans to the safe area layout card. If you wanted to have this, then it's okay. You can have that. Okay, that is some pretty detailed feature. Okay, let's just move forward and maybe have some. Let's see here. What do we have? Let's remove this. To be, let's set the width to be of width, and let's have here, let's say maybe 100, I don't know. Let's see how that looks. Okay, pretty nice. And yeah, you can play around with it. What I will just do for last in this episode is just go into the cell and change this maybe to the background color of purple. So you can see, and you can of course lay out buttons and so on. This is your playground that you can use. Just wait for that. Really, really nice. Okay, now that is it for this tutorial. We have added our simple list, and in the next one we are going to, besides adding this top view or a bottom view, we are going to talk about headers and footers and how you can add them to your simple list. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, and hit that notification bell to get notified. Now it is your turn. Let me know how you feel about the list view controller, of course, in the comments down below. I'm really interested how you would use it. If you have any questions about it, go ahead and comment down below. I'm eager to find out your opinion and to answer your questions. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.